Good evening. It's late at night, so I decided to just turn off my camera. We've learned a lot of formulas, and it can be quite confusing, so I decided for this video to compile everything that we know and add a little bit more knowledge by introducing a few more equations. But this is the first equation that we ever learned. These are the important formulas involving point charges. So these are the formulas that we have when we are given point charges. The first is just Coulomb's law, or the electrostatic force between two charged objects. We all know about this, right? So if you want to pause the video, you can just do so. But we all know this. The second is the electric field produced by a charged point object. Its magnitude is kqs over r squared, and its direction is radially outward or inward. If this charge is negative charge, then its direction is radially inward. Notice the difference. For electrostatic force, there are two charges. For electric field, it is the source charge that is changing the properties of the space around it, creating electric fields. The third equation is the electrostatic force experienced by a test charge due to an electric field. So the magnitude is Fe is equal to Q naught E. So when we are putting a test charge in a region of electric field, that test charge will feel an electric force. The direction is the same as the electric field direction if the test charge is positive. So if the test charge is positive, the electric force that our test charge feels is pointing in the same direction as the direction of the electric field. But in this example, I used a negative test charge. So even if the electric field produced by our source charge at this location is to the right, the electric force is to the left because that's what negative test charges do. The force acting on them is opposite the direction of the electric field. This is one equation that we haven't talked about, and it is the electric potential energy between two point charges. So if you have two point charges Q1 and Q2, they have an associated electric potential energy. And this electric potential energy is a scalar. So let's look at situation A and situation B. Which do you think has the greater electric potential energy? Or greater stored energy? If you answered situation B, then you are correct. So you can see these two positive test charges want to repel each other, but you put them together so close that there's a lot of energy stored between the two. So here I have a question. What happens to the electric potential energy in a system of two point charges if the two charges are so far away, infinitely far away from each other? Well, if they are infinitely far away from each other, then R is infinity. Because in this formula, R is the separation distance between the two charges. And any number that you divide by infinity becomes zero. In other words, doesn't matter what the value of Q1 and Q2 are. Is, but if you're dividing it by infinity, it's like dividing this numerator by a very big number. And If you divide the numerator with a very large denominator, the answer is very small and actually goes to zero. So when two charges are so far apart, then they have no electric potential energy stored between them. I just want to prove that we can associate an electric potential energy in this system. So in the case of two positive charges that are repelling, if you draw a system schema, it's just Q1 and Q2, and there is an electrostatic force between them. If you consider a system to be both Q1 and Q2, you have internal forces, just the electric force, and you have no external forces. And by the way, this internal force is the electric force, which is a conservative force. So therefore, there is a potential energy associated with this system. That's why we have a formula for a potential energy for this system, because the only internal force is an electric force, which is a conservative force. And since there are no external forces in our system, we can also use this conservation of mechanical energy equation. So calculate the electric potential energy between two protons 2 micrometers apart. So that should be easy. All we have to do is really, we just need to substitute 8.99 times 10 to the 9, and a proton has a charge of 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19. So Q2 is another proton, so I can just square that. And the distance between them is 2 times 10 to the negative 6. Since I don't have a calculator, I will give you the responsibility of computing that and let me know in class. So there's another concept. The electric potential created by a charged point object whose reference is V equals 0 at R equals infinity. So electric potential V, the formula is KQS over R. So it is a number that you assign. It is a property in space. Another property in space caused by the presence of a charge. And QS here is the source, and R is a distance from the source to any point in space. So the SI unit of V, this is joules per coulomb. So just to summarize, the presence of a source charged point object causes the space around it to have electric properties. With this source charge, the space around it will have both electric field, which is a vector, and electric potential, which is a scalar. So each point in space will have electric field and potential. So we have an E here and V at this point. This point will also have an E and a V, and this point will also have an E and a V. So what does electric field do? And when you put a test charge at that point, the electric field will give the test charge electric force. And the electric potential will give the test charge electric potential energy. So the electric field will give Newton's force, the electric potential will give energy, joules. So, comparing further, these are the two electric properties of locations in space. And as I mentioned earlier, these properties of space will only exist if there are charges nearby. And really, that's on Earth, there are charges everywhere because there are atoms everywhere. And atoms are composed of protons, electrons, and neutrons, with the proton being positively charged and electrons being negatively charged. So there are many charges everywhere, point charges, so you can say that all points in space on Earth and in many places around the universe have electric field and electric potential. Symbol for electric field is E, electric potential is V, as a unit is newtons per coulomb for electric field and joules per coulomb for electric potential. Electric field is a vector and electric potential is a scalar. Both are present when there are source charges nearby. When you put a test charge at a point in space, the electric field will cause that test charge to feel an electric force. The electric potential will cause the test charge to get an electric potential energy value. So, in order to solve for the electric force, you just use this formula, Q naught times E, where E is the electric field. To get the magnitude of electric potential energy that the system gains, it's just equal to Q naught times V, where V is the electric potential. Electric potential difference is just the difference between electric potential of two points. Here, RB is the final point, RA is the initial point. So it's the final V minus initial V. V here is not velocity, okay? This is electric potential. And delta V is known as voltage, also known as electric potential difference. So another term for electric potential difference is voltage. Let's proceed to the next slide. Calculate the magnitude of the electric field and electric potential produced by a point charge 2 times 10 to the negative 10 at the point 3 nanometers away. So this point charge is actually a source charge, 2 times 10 to the negative 10. Coulombs. And here this small circle is actually just a dot in space. There's nothing there. But because it is near a source charge, then this point in space will have both an electric field and an electric potential. We can calculate both if we use the formula E equals KQ over R squared. And if you want to get the V, you'll get here newtons per coulomb, and here you'll get joules per coulomb, KQ over R. So that's how you solve it, where R is 3 nanometers. Notice that the only difference between E and V is that for E, R is squared, but for V, R is not squared. Also, E is a vector and V is a scalar. So I'll leave it to you to solve that problem. Question 3. What electric force will a test proton feel at that point, and what is the electric potential energy of the system? So if we put a test proton here, it will be influenced. So our proton is 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. This point has an electric field and electric potential because there is a source charge nearby. So this test proton will feel an electric force given by, so let's just call this Q naught test proton. the electric field which you calculated in question 2. And because there is an electric potential also at this point, our test charge will also nope. Let me just erase that. Our system will now have an electric potential energy thanks to the electric potential at that point. So that's it, that's how you solve it. How about important formulas involving constant electric fields? So the electric force experienced by a test charge in a constant electric field. So this test charge will obviously feel an electric force, and what's special about the Fe equals Q naught E is that this magnitude is constant all throughout the displacement. So wherever, it's not unlike when the source is just a point charge, the force constantly changes. But between two metal plates where the electric field is constant, since E is constant, Fe is also constant. That means that the acceleration is constant, or the rate of change in velocity is constant. The direction is the same as the electric field if the test charge is positive, and opposite as the electric field direction if the test charge is negative. So here's another formula, it's the work done by the electric field on the test charge. Recall that the general formula for work for this is for constant forces. Work is Fd cosine phi. So our F is just QE, that's why it's there. And look, phi is the short angle between the force and the displacement. And for a positive charge, right, so phi here is equal to zero because the direction of the force is parallel to the direction of the displacement. So it's the same direction. So actually this formula actually reduces to Q naught ED, since we're substituting 0 here and cosine 0 is 1. Another important formula is the change in electric potential energy between two points in a region of constant electric field. So here we have, if we consider only the charge object as our system, then we have one external force, the electric force. And if there is an external force acting on a system or an object, we can use the work energy theorem, wherein the work created by this external force is equal to the change in kinetic energy of the object. But if we consider both our charge and metal plates as one system, then as you can see, there's only one internal force and no external forces. So we can use the conservation of mechanical energy, delta Ke plus delta Epe equals zero. If we combine both equations, we get that delta Epe is the negative of the work done by the electric field. The change in electric potential energy. How much does the energy, electric potential energy of the system changes, is equivalent to the negative of the work done by the electric field. So this is a new concept, the change in electric potential between points A and B. So that is defined by the change in electric potential energy divided by the test charge, where the test charge is positive by definition. So by definition, when we define electric potential difference, We always use a test charge, so Q naught here should always be positive. Second line, we see that we substituted delta EPE equals negative WE, and further substitutions. Now in the third line, so this is what we had work done by electric field is Q naught ED cosine phi, but phi here is zero, so therefore what's really left is makancel ni is negative ED. Here, this is another way to calculate the electric potential difference in a region where the electric field is constant. As you can see, it doesn't depend on any test charge. Going back from the previous slide, we'll show that delta V is also defined in terms of you can also get delta V if you have a test charge and you place it in the electric field and calculate the change in electric potential energy. But this is another way of solving the electric potential. This is the last slide. Point A and B are 2 centimeters apart. A test charge of Q equals 2 microcoulombs starts at A and accelerates to B due to the electrostatic force. So the electric field is constant, 20,000 volts per meter. This is supposedly newtons per coulomb. Right. Calculate, but I think newtons per coulomb and volts per meter are the same. Calculate the electric potential difference between A and B. So we're asked to calculate the delta V between A and B. That would be VB minus VA. So, what formulas do we know about delta V? We know that delta V is delta EPE over Q naught. We have that definition. We know what Q naught is, but we don't know what delta EPE is. But we know that delta EPE is equal to the negative of the work done by the electric field. And the work done by the electric field is the test charge times the electric field times D. No cosine phi anymore because cosine 0 is 1. So what is given? We are given E and D and Q naught. E is 20,000 newtons per coulomb. D is 2 centimeters, Q naught is 2 microcoulombs. So basically, we resubstituted there, and this one we resubstituted here. So we will get delta V. So I'll leave you guys to do it. Thank you.